Hi, I'm Jacob, and this is Alex, and this is Mercer's Movie Minute. We're going to talk to you about the new trilogy of the M. Night world. It was like, you got Unbreakable, Split, and Mr. Glass, the newest Mr. Glass. So we're just going to go each one by one. So how'd you feel about Unbreakable?
Unbreakable, I enjoyed it. I thought it was interesting for what it was. I don't know. I don't really have like really in-depth thoughts about it. It's been a few months since I saw it last, but I enjoyed it. I thought it was one of M. Night's better movies.
Oh, definitely. I saw it like 2 weeks ago, so I could prepare my girlfriend to see Glass, because she saw Split, but not Unbreakable. And I thought of it as kind of one of those against the grain kind of movies, because superhero movies weren't really big back then when it was first made, but it was definitely one of those more character-based instead of plot-based superhero movies that I kind of appreciate about it. You know what I mean? Because nowadays it's definitely more plot based. You got Thor trying to save the world, Captain America just stopping the Nazis.
Because that was kind of like the era of the early 2000s like superhero movie genre, where it was definitely like a lot more character driven. Like Spider-Man 2 is an example, I think, and I will always quote this as the best movie of all time, where it focuses on like just Peter Parker like losing his powers because of the stress he has in his life of like trying to juggle everything instead of him trying to like stop the bad guy. Mm-hmm.
That's how I always feel superhero movies kind of should be. Like the idea of being more human than just super. And that's actually what Unbreakable is. It's about a man being human, but kind of coming to terms with being super, so to speak.
Yeah.
Yeah. But then with Split, you said you had some mixed feelings about that.
I will say, because it's a really well-done movie.
Yeah.
I will say that it's really good. It's well done, well executed. I just didn't care for it personally.
Yeah.
I will admit it's fantastic. It deserves all the praise it gets. It was well done. Like the twists in it were cause there was like a few twists, like one towards the end about like, one girl like I think she like killed her dad or something. She killed her dad or something. And that was really well thought out, because I thought the twist was just going to be like, oh, he had all these personalities or him or something.
Mm. Oh, no, she hadn't killed her dad. She was abused by her uncle.
Yeah.
That's what it was, yeah.
Yeah, and that was a twist. I'm like, wow, that was a really well done twist.
Yeah.
But just overall, I'm like, it's a good horror movie, but I don't know. Like, good horror movies are, like, they're either really good and I enjoy them, like stuff like Hereditary and The Witch.
Oh, yes, definitely.
And Split was a good one. I don't know why. I just kind of, I'm like, it was good. I just don't, don't care as much.
I could talk all day about The Witch and Hereditary, honestly.
I know, I will too. I will defend those, like, till the end of time.
Honestly, like, they're so well written and everything, but I guess we're not talking about that today, unfortunately. Yeah. With Split, I love it. That's how I am, because, like, just the acting that James McAvoy, 23 characters.
Like, every time he came on screen as, like, a different character, I'm like, man, this is one, like, it's just, like, that's one person doing all that. I just thought that, like, his acting is fantastic.
Mm-hmm. And he got really frustrated once, like, with trying to play all these characters, and he punched a wall. He made his hand just inflate, and there's a point in the film where you can see his hand just all puffy, but he just beat through it, even though his hand was hurting, like, all ever. So, like, he's very dedicated to the film, any film he plays. And, like, I don't know, like, I have gripes with a lot of M. Night movies, as I imagine, you know, a lot of people do.
Yeah, but, like, there are some terrible not ones. Good ones out
not
there.
Not good ones, I guess, is the polite word to say. But in the case of Split, I just, like, I give it, like, an 8.5, like, personally.
It's weird, because it's coming out of an era of, like, really bad M. Night movies.
I get
and
you.
Then
yeah.
Split just comes out, and it's like, wow, that was really good.
Yeah, and that was like, I think that was because he wrote it earlier in his career. And earlier in his career, he had some good movies, like The Sixth Sense and all that. And then Split just kind of came out, and it was like, as you said, a completely different M. Night.
Yeah.
And it's like, I didn't like the psychologist, though, like the old woman psychologist. Like,
I thought it was kind of interesting.
Yeah.
But it didn't really like, I don't know, it just didn't have any like impact.
That's like in terms of like a movie, she just wasn't that good as an actor. That's my gripe. I love the concepts. I just didn't think it was properly executed.
Well, it's like like the concept, I mean, just like in general.
Yeah, yeah.
Like it's kind of like the concept of, they've been doing a lot more recently, like having a movie, but it's just like a computer screen.
Yeah.
Where there's like some movies that do that really well, like Searching, I've heard, is like, it does that fantastically. And then there's stuff like Unfriended, which is
terrible. Yeah. So I was like, I've always wanted to see Searching. That's been on my list for a while.
It's on my list too, because I keep hearing it's really good.
Oh, definitely. Like one of the rare on-screen type of movies that are actually good.
I really like that concept. Mm-hmm. I think that can be done really well, like in horror movies.
Mm-hmm.
It just...
They just don't know how to do it.
Yeah.
Because they just always want to put like, somebody's missing, there's a murderer
they
behind them.
They want there to be like a supernatural...
Yeah, there doesn't have to be.
Jump scare element. It's like,
it doesn't have to be for that. Like, it's you're on a computer.
Because even still, like, I mean... Like, because a lot of horror movies are now, like, supernatural jump scare stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then Split, which was a horror movie.
Yeah.
That wasn't supernatural at all.
No, I mean, well, I mean,
you could
end,
say,
but,
like, some of the stuff with the Beast was supernatural.
Yeah.
But they even had, like, I don't know if the science, I'm pretty sure the science was fake.
Oh, definitely.
I don't know for certain. But they did have at least some science they explained in the movie. It's like, it's not supernatural.
It's like the idea of like changing bodily functions, like the idea of him being diabetic, like in one personality was interesting. In the real world, obviously,
I don't think
that's
how that works.
That's not how it works.
I'm not a doctor though, so I can't.
I know, like my girlfriend, she works in education. Mm-hmm. And like when she saw that movie, she's like, this is not how it works at all. Cause she has to study that with children all the time. So like the idea of like different, like a psychosis or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, so she told me that and I was like, yeah, I could see that not being right. It was like with the Beast, like that's where it really flipped the switch into supernatural.
Yeah.
That's why it's, but that's only at the end. So that's why
but
it's only really
even
horror.
Still, it wasn't like the standard.
Yeah. It definitely wasn't.
Oh, somebody died here, and there's a haunted computer or whatever. Mm-hmm.
That's probably why I liked it the most because it wasn't like your standard.
It was supernatural, but not
light. Like the lightest amount of supernatural.
Yeah.
And then we get into Glass.
Yeah.
Now you haven't seen it, but we're going to talk about it.
I haven't seen Glass.
Like, when it comes to an M. Night movie, there's usually the preconceived notion that it's not going to be as good as the trailers make it out, which in hindsight is true. But my thought process on his movies when I saw Split completely changed, like my idea of M. Night movies altogether, because as we said, they're not that good. But Split was just such a different movie altogether. So that was just an amazing movie. I could go into, well, we just did, why that's good, we just did. But then you get into Glass. It doesn't really match up with Split all that much in terms of like quality, like, or even Unbreakable for that
matter. I feel like Glass is, again, I haven't seen it, so I might be wrong, but from what I've seen, it seems more of like a sequel to Unbreakable with, because I know Split was always made to be part of the, Unbreakable cinematic universe or M. Night's cinematic universe. So we don't know. It's not all connected.
Yeah.
But it feels like it's more of an Unbreakable sequel with Split as part of it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I might be wrong. Again, I haven't seen it. But I don't know. It's just kind of what it feels like from the trailers.
You could definitely put it that way. But in the case of M. Night, any twist he can add, he will add, and he made sure it connected with Unbreakable at the end of Split, no matter what. And then you go into the Glass, and they're all just apprehended and just like to be cured of what they assume is a fake, you know, mental idea of them being superheroes. And in the film, it certainly isn't the case. And there's a twist that's involved with the film itself about like them being apprehended and for what reason that is. And that's partially why I think Glass kind of fails. Because M. Night loves his twists, but and in the case of some of them, the twist is like kind of satisfying. Like in the case of The Sixth Sense, or in the case of, what was it? In the case of Unbreakable.
Yeah,
like in case, then, like, it's like, oh, like Samuel Jackson is like.
Yeah, Samuel Jackson's a bad guy.
Yeah, ooh. Oh my, yes.
Which, that was like one of the moments where like, wow, hey.
I like that.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I didn't see that coming at all.
Mm-hmm. And then in Glass, it just kind of...
But it's like, also though, in Unbreakable though, you can kind of see it.
Mm-hmm.
Cause
yeah.
It's like,
yeah.
It's hinted at, like they're polar opposites, but you don't really put the pieces together.
Yeah.
Because then there's also, you know, twists like The Village, which is, you know, and then Signs, which is not the worst twist, but it's still like, kind of dumb.
Yeah, it's like, okay, I guess that's how aliens can die. Water.
Yeah.
There's like... And it's just like with Glass, it comes out of left field, even more so than Signs or even Unbreakable or even Split, for that matter. Mm-hmm. It's like it doesn't add anything to the plot. It doesn't. It's just there, and it feels like it feels kind of like he was sitting in a boardroom. Mm-hmm. And everybody's like, you need to connect this to more movies. So he made a vague connection.
So
like,
are they actually starting the M. Night cinematic universe?
I kind of hope, because like, M. Night, just he has good ideas that just need to be executed well. And if he makes an actual cinematic universe, I'll be happy, because he can just explore all of it.
It's one of those things where it's like, it has no reason to really exist, but because it does, I'm happy.
Yeah.
Just for no reason other than this is just something that just doesn't make any sense, but why not?
Yeah, that's just like, he's a strange creature.
Yeah.
And I'll always love him for that. It's like, but I did find some good things with Glass. Mm. The acting was wonderful. James McAvoy, as we had just talked, like his 23 personalities, he really goes strong into that.
James McAvoy and Samuel Jackson, they're fantastic actors. Mm-hmm. Bruce Willis, I mean, depending on
the movie.
Yeah. And I don't know who Sarah Paulson is, I won't lie.
Yeah, I was mostly excited to see her in this because of American Horror Story. Yeah. I was like, oh, I know her from that.
I've never seen that.
Yeah, it's like, so. But beyond that, I was kind of like, she's in it. Mm. And it's the case of, the acting was good, but there were times where the writing was stunted.
Yeah.
And that's really, like, I'm very nitpicky with how stories kind of play out in plot and writing. Mm. So, and like, the way that Sarah Paulson's character kind of played out, it was very kind of forced in certain places where, like, I'm going to fix you. Everything's going to be totally fine. And then especially at the end where she's involved in the twist, it just didn't work out well.
It just comes out of nowhere.
It does. And like, that's why it's, like, it's going to be one of those movies where I'd be like, you can see it once and then just be fine with it. Kind of like how I was with, like, the Hobbit trilogy. I was like...
That was one of those things. I'm like, it's out there.
It's out there.
Didn't need three movies.
You didn't need it all.
We got them.
It was like...
If they made it one movie.
Yeah, if they made it one movie, like, I feel like that could have been fantastic. But it's like,
but
oh well. It's like,
as three, it's just too much.
Yeah, it's just way too much. And in the case of like this, I feel like there's never too much of M. Night. Like, there's the difference, but at the same time, it's like,
it's just M. Night's just interesting to watch for just what it is.
Yeah, and it's like, if you want to watch like a good M. Night movie, just watch Unbreakable or Split. You don't necessarily...
Or Sixth Sense.
Or Sixth Sense. I mean, like, I meant to say within this trilogy. Within this world he wants to build. Just see Split. Just see Unbreakable. You don't necessarily need to see this. It doesn't... If anything, it feels like a tad bit of a disappointment at the end because of how the characters end out. I give it, like, a 6.
Well, I think because Unbreakable came out in, like, 2006, I want to say.
I feel like somewhere around there.
Yeah, somewhere around there. So it's been, like... 13 years, mm-hmm. people have wanted a sequel. So it's like one of those things where it's bound to be somewhat disappointing to most people. Because in the case of like many things like taking a while to come out, people like build up
hype and everything. Yeah. And it's like, and there's just so many like years in difference to writing style and how he's evolved. And like I said, Split was written in the early era and then he wrote Glass now, so it's gonna be completely different.
It's kind of like what happened with this isn't a movie, but like Samurai Jack.
Yeah.
Like, cause there was I think 10 years between like the fourth season,
something like that,
and the fifth season coming out, which the fifth season was great.
Yeah.
But like the last episode was just rushed.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's why people were disappointed. Is they built up this whole thing in their head, and then
I feel like they could have had maybe two more episodes.
Maybe
two or three. It's like I'd really like.
I watched it last month.
So. Really? Yeah. I was like, I was there every week to watch those episodes. That was my jam.
Yeah.
Like,
But Glass. I still didn't see it, but I will.
You should.
When it comes out on like digital, I'll probably watch it.
That's when you should see it. Much like I didn't see the last like Hobbit film until it came out on digital because I didn't care that much.
I do like the poster for Glass because it was done by a famous comic book artist, Alex Ross.
That's all that matters.
Yeah. if Alex Ross is attached to it, it's good.
Mm-hmm. All good.
Yeah. Yeah.